Hi, I'm Dr. Cher, and today I'm going to continue part two of what I started last week, which is about the worry that a lot of people have is, will they stick to a program? I hear this a lot from people because based on past experiences where they haven't been able to stick, whether to a program, whether they're doing it themselves, whether it's under supervision, but it's this underlying, call it belief, worry, anxiety that, oh, I don't know if I'll stick to it this time, what's going to be different? So as I said before, what I'm taking you through is like, okay, let's look at what happened before. When you really figure out what is it that was interfering with you being able to stick with it, and when you identify that, then you're going to know, okay, well, this is what I need going forward. And therefore, you're going to feel much more confident in yourself that you'll stick with it because you've figured out what was missing, what you needed, what you do need. Last week we talked about the body side of things from a body standpoint. So number one was not getting results. Therefore, people aren't seeing results because they're not using the right method for themselves. Well, guess what? They're not going to stick with it. Over time, anybody's going to give up. Not your fault, but that's what's going to happen. It's just the wrong plan. The other part of the body part was just not feeling great, feeling hungry, feeling tired, just how you're eating isn't agreeing with you. Therefore, again, pretty hard to stick with it. And especially very hard to carry on into maintenance if that's not how you want to eat going forward. So today I'm going to talk about the mindset side of things. And basically there's three areas. So the first one, and I hear this a lot from people, one of the biggest ones when they first come, you know, speak with me is in the past, often what's tripped them up, why they didn't stick with something, it just got too complicated. The timing, the planning, the prepping, you know, thinking about food all the time, trying to figure out what they need to eat, how much, their macros. It's just so complicated that over time they kind of, you could call it like diet burnout, you know, decision fatigue, whatever you want to name it. That is often the reason over time people start just don't stick with it. It's too complicated. It's taking way too much time and energy and effort than what they can give to the whole process, particularly when people, you know, are busy, they've got a lot on the go and they've got careers and families and all sorts of stuff. I mean, people need simple solutions, straightforward solutions. They need a plan that's going to work for them with all that they have going on in their life, that's what was missing before. They didn't realize it. So it isn't so much they couldn't, well, they didn't stick with it, but the thing that was contributing to that was too complicated. So what does that mean they need? That means they need something that's going to work for them, that's straightforward, there's clarity, there's structure, that they know they can integrate into their lifestyle. And this is very important. I mean, one of my key pillars in my five principled program is about routine. So the more you can get into a routine, the easier it is. And therefore, having simple routines makes it even easier. So reflect on that. Maybe it's just whatever you did before, it was just too complicated for you. And there's no possibility you could have really stuck with it without having, you know, an iron will of self-discipline. And you probably have a lot better things to do with your time than dedicate that much time and energy to just trying to eat, right, at the end of the day. So, and that's, you know, one of the things that I hear a lot from people. And I've seen people go through, not just life is ideal when they do the program. I mean, I've seen people in the program and they've had, you know, a parent that's been diagnosed with cancer. Now they got to run around taking them to the hospital. I've had people that where they've had, you know, children have been ill and they've had to go back and forth to the hospital, job changes. So if it's a straightforward enough approach and program, then even when the wheels spin off the bus, you know, as it can happen, they can stick with it. And I've actually had it happen with quite a few people in the throes of it where they've had somebody very close to them pass away. They carry on because it's simple. So you need, if that's the thing that tripped you up before, then you need a simple, straightforward solution that's actually going to work for your program or for your lifestyle. The other one that trips people up a lot is the cravings, stress eating, emotional eating, these things. Again, this is very much a mindset issue. So, you know, again, reflect on where you feel that you didn't stick with it. Kind of go, what was it that took you off the path? Maybe body wise, maybe you're getting results. Maybe you felt good with how you're eating on the program. Maybe it was simple enough, but oh man, those cravings just kicked in, or those the emotional eating, the stress eating kicked into gear, and it just, you know, you were no longer in control of the ship, so to speak. You know, those things took over and you couldn't stick with it. So, you know, that is, that, I mean, that's actually quite a complicated part. But if you identify that's what tripped you up, then you know, okay, going forward, in order to be able to stick with a plan, I know I need to get support around this. I need to have something that's going to help me address when, you know, give me strategies. Why did those happen? What can I do differently? One of the things in one of the pillars of my program I talked was having a really powerful why. Like, why is it that you want to lose weight in the first place? And that will drive the motivation, but it has to be a sort of an intrinsic value-driven motivation. When that's in place and you get strategies to help to manage the cravings, the stress eating, this type of stuff, so you really are getting at the root cause, then that's going to support you in riding through those and being able to stick with the plan. So if that's been your kind of Achilles heel, then you know I need to do something where I'm going to get that support. Otherwise, it probably will trip you up again. That one I would say is also particularly important when you're looking at being able to keep the weight off, because it'll come back and bite you in the derriere as a lifestyle down the road when you're no longer, quote, on a program or doing a diet. You need to have gotten a handle on those things so that you are in the driver's seat. That's why in my program I call it body freedom. It's not just about the body, it's also mind freedom, that you are eating from choice. You've got a handle on those very powerful cravings and old habits. But you know now that as you go through the program that you're in a position that you can override them. You're in control. It's not the other way around. So that's a big one that happens to a lot of people. So that's something to be aware of. You know, and the last one I would say is just generally about motivation. And some people will look back and they'll think, well, no, I was doing okay. I was getting results. I was feeling good. No cravings. I just kind of lost interest. I lost motivation. And I've already mentioned this. That's where, you know, what was your reason for losing weight back in the past? Maybe it wasn't a powerful enough reason why. Maybe it was a very short-term goal. It was like, oh, it was for a trip. It was for a reunion. I had a job interview. I had an event coming up. I thought I should. So you did it. You stuck with it. But then you just, yeah, for whatever reason, the motivation was gone. So that's why, if that's the case, then you know, okay, you need help identifying what is your deeper value-driven motivation to lose weight, but not just lose weight. It's actually to be healthier. It's actually to have a lifestyle where you can feel great, you look great, you want to eat well, you want to establish healthy routines because you value your body, you value your health, and have a great lifestyle, right? So you can have some indulgences. So in order to kind of get through to that end result, your motivation needs to be very value-driven, very intrinsic. So it's an internal motivation. It's not something externally, because those things come and go, whereas the internal one is with you the whole way. So with that, if that's one of the ones, then definitely you want to look for help with that so that you can keep that motivation on the radar and keep you moving in the right direction. So in summary, in around, if you're worried, you're not going to stick with it, again, look back. Is it a body issue? Is it a mindset issue? What tripped you up in the past that caused you to not stick with it? And then recognize, okay, I just need to get the right thing in place. And I have seen it with people that have come to me. I mean, one person recently, she just completed the program, but you know, again, she was struggling. She was not sticking with it because she wasn't getting results. She was hungry. She wasn't feeling great. Had cravings, you know, and as we got her going on the program, first of all, she was getting results. So her motivation was huge. She was feeling fantastic, unlike before. So that was highly motivating. So her ability to stick with it. And then even, and this woman, like I was amazed at her, she ended up, actually somebody in her house got COVID. So they were having people bring them food. Her fridge had broken, so she had a little bar fridge. Like all these things, right? It could be so easy to have just said, this is, forget it, I'm not sticking with it. And she was very concerned she wouldn't stick with it when she started. But she went through all these hurdles, the fridge, dealing with a family member with COVID, high stress, you know, and as it was, I mean, the family member passed away. So, and even then, people dropping over food. She's just carrying on. She said, you know, because she felt great, it gave her strength, it gave her just this feeling of doing something for herself. So her ability to stick with it, it was there. It was probably always there. It's just what she was doing in the past wasn't filling the gaps that she needed so she could tap into this inner strength that she had. She was just missing a few, there were a few missing puzzle pieces, I guess you could say. And when once those were in place, I mean, she was like, you know, like rock of steel in terms of follow through. So it's completely doable. So just reflect, look at, you know, what happened in the past, take off the judgment hat, the self-critical hat, anything like that, going, what was it really? Okay, then you'll know, what do I need going forward? What are the gaps? What do I need to make sure I have in place? When you do, you'll stick with it. I see it all the time. So if you think you need some any help with that, please take the time to reach out to me. You can book a complimentary call or join the Facebook group. We have a Facebook group. Anything like that, jump on some of my webinars, get more support around this, because it is absolutely, I believe that you can do it. Okay, so take care, and I'll be back next week.